In this video, we're going to learn two other ways that we can charge objects besides friction. The first of those ways is called charging by contact. And I'm going to use the same process. I'm going to take my magic wand and I'm going to take my wool. Okay. I'm going to get it all nice and charged, right? You can hear the static. Okay. And I'm going to actually not just bring it close, but I'm actually going to touch it this time. I touched it. Okay. And now, what do you think is going to happen when I bring it close? Oh, weird. Now it repels. What's that all about? Check this out. Oh my God. I'm really kind of getting a crazy effect here. Straight up magic. You guys know that I haven't touched this at all, right? Wow. What the heck's going on there? A minute ago, it actually attracted. Now it's repelling. Stalba, what's going on? Obviously, I'm going to tell you what's going on, okay? We just charged this little piece of aluminum foil by contact. And what does that mean? Well, it means I am going to make another little picture here of the aluminum foil. This is a string. That's the aluminum foil, okay? And again, I brought my rod up close, and it had a negative charge on it, okay? But this time, instead of just bringing it close, I actually made contact. So what do you think happens when I have this supercharged thing, all this negative charge over here, and it contacts this? I bet you can guess. These electrons are going to be like, hey, I'm tired of being stuck in this room with all these other electrons. I'm getting out of here, right? So they jump ship, right? It's a conductor. Electrons will move farther away from other electrons. So that means that then I have a negative charge on this object as well. There's negativity, 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 right? So now half the charge that was on here, I'm going to make some of these go away because some of the charge actually moved, but half the charge that was on here is now on there. So what happens when we have two negative objects getting close to each other? They repel, they push away. So what do you see? You see exactly that. Rubbing this, I touch it, now it actually repels it because the electrons on here and the electrons on here don't want nothing to do with each other. So there is an electrostatic force that is pushing this away. Pretty cool, huh? We just charged this by contact. What else do I want you to know about charging by contact? Just that if, you know, I have two objects, let's say this is object one and this is object two, right? And object two, the unit of charge is called coulombs. So object two has 10 coulombs, let's say, okay? And then they touch. What happens is that they reach an equilibrium where they both have the same charge. So after they touch, then there'll be a situation where then, so this is positive, just a positive one. This guy will be positive with a 5 coulomb charge, and this guy will be positive with a 5 coulomb charge. They will end up being equal, okay? Not too tough. I've mentioned there is two other ways to charge, and there's this one last way is called charging by induction, and this is a little bit trickier, but a lot cooler. Like this is kind of clever. Okay, so let's suppose that I wanted to be charged positively, right? Like my life as a neutrally charged person is really boring. And I'm like, I would love to just have a positive charge and experience what life would be like that. Okay, here's what you would do. Here's one thing you could do, okay? Let's suppose that I have some conducting ball over here, okay? And you can actually see this on the slide. This is charging by induction. So I have some conducting ball, and let's say that it's neutral. And I bring towards it a positively charged rod. Okay, and in order to do this process, I have to have my fingers on it, and there's not enough room, so I'm only a 3-fingered person or a 4-fingered person, whatever that is, okay? And so I'm touching this ball. Those of you who saw some of the hands that I drew last year, that's actually pretty impressive considering it only has 4 fingers. Okay, neutral ball. I bring a positively charged rod to it. What do you think is going to happen? Well, positive attracts negative, right? For the most part, the body is conducting, okay? It's not a great conductor, but it is a conductor. And so the electrons that are in my body are gonna be like, oh, I'm sensing this positive rod over here. I'm really feeling it. And so those electrons that are in your body run over here and they get as close as they possibly can to the rod. Only problem is that leaves you with a net what? Positive charge, right? So all those electrons go over there, that's gonna leave a bunch of positive ions in the arm, okay? At which point, all you need to do then is let go of the ball. And you still have a positive charge, right? And that positive charge will be distributed throughout the entire body, okay? That's pretty cool. This rod did not even have to touch me. There was no contact. That rod did not even have to touch me in order for me through induction, and I'll write that again up here. This is called charging by induction. This over here is charging by contact. And the last one we learned was charging by friction. Okay. So this rod did not even have to touch me, and I still gained a net positive charge. Pretty cool. So practice those, study those. Once again, it's charging by friction. I'm actually pulling electrons off of atoms and molecules and leaving this with a negative charge and this with a positive charge, okay? It's actually like tearing, that's the charging by friction. Charging by contact is actually touching, and now they repel. And charging by induction is really charging by using the fact that electrons want to flow to get electrons from one object to another, leaving the original object with a net charge, okay? Those are the three ways to charge an object, and they also explain so many of the static electric effects that we see in the world, everything from why you shock somebody when you shake their hand to why a balloon sticks to the wall after you rub it on your head, and why your laundry sticks together after you get it out of the dryer. Okay, in the next video, we're gonna be talking about how much charge an electron actually has and a few other various things. I'll see you there.